All right, we've been working at learning each individual sound of English for a while now. But you may wonder why it even matters if you know how to make each individual sound correctly. Well, the reason is simple, but one that most people don't think about. If your pronunciation of each sound is correct, then your pronunciation of the whole word is more likely to be correct as well. The reality is that many English learners want to improve their pronunciation in order to reduce their accent so that they can improve their communication with other English speakers. Notice that I've said reduce and not eliminate. You don't necessarily need to eliminate your accent. It is evidence of your culture and prior language, which isn't a bad thing. There are actually many different accents within the English language as well, and there is nothing wrong with that. The goal here is simply to reduce your accent enough to improve your communication with other English speakers. So today I've decided to share with you 6 tips to reduce your accent. Number 1, perfect the pronunciation of individual sounds. I know that this is tedious and may seem like a lot of work, but without being able to say each sound correctly, it will be nearly impossible to say full words correctly. Sounds are the building blocks for all of speech, and without proper sound pronunciation, I can almost guarantee that you will have an accent. I know that you can't stay at the sound level forever. But even once your vocabulary is large and your grammar is excellent, it can still be beneficial to break a word down into its individual sounds in order to improve your pronunciation. Number 2, do you need a faster solution to your accent issue than spending hours improving your sound quality? Speak more slowly. By slowing down your speech, you will often improve your accent and understandability. How does this work, you may ask? Well, it really comes down to our brains. By speaking slower, it gives your brain more time to think through each individual sound before you make it, increasing the likelihood that you won't make silly mistakes. Not only that, but it gives you more time to enunciate each sound more clearly. It also gives the listener more time to process the information that you are giving, which can help with how much they understand, even if you do speak with an accent. Number 3, learn proper intonation, rhythm, and stress. In English, speakers place stress on a specific syllable of a word. This particular sound is emphasized while the other parts of the word are typically said faster and in a different tone. Similarly, the speaker will often vary the pitch of their voice throughout a sentence by having it go up and down while they speak. This helps the speaker to get their message across correctly. Finally, rhythm helps the speaker share their thoughts by emphasizing certain words in a sentence. Much like with stress, rhythm references how we combine words in a sentence that are stressed with words that are unstressed. Without proper stress, rhythm, and intonation, messages that even use the correct vocabulary and grammar can easily be misunderstood by a native speaker because tone of voice is believed to account for 38% of communication, while the words themselves only account for 7%. This should emphasize to you the importance of understanding and practicing these components of the language. Number 4, listen to others speaking the language. This tip is especially important in order to help you understand more about the rhythm, intonation, and stress that we just talked about. Unfortunately, unlike learning grammar rules, there is no simple trick to learning these aspects of the language. The only way to do it is to hear others speak and pay attention to how they emphasize certain sounds and words. Since intention impacts rhythm, intonation, and stress, the same words do not always sound the same. This is why you will hear people suggesting that you watch TV shows or movies in English. It helps you hear speech in conversation while allowing you the opportunity to pause, rewind, and listen again if needed. Other ideas to practice your listening skills are listening to the radio, audiobooks, or even just other people as they walk by you on the street. Number 5. Focus on contractions and slang language. This is important because it is related to the above 2 points. Even though it is grammatically correct to say cannot, for example, it sounds quite formal in speech and is rarely used in spoken English. Rather, it is often shortened to the contraction can't. These small nuances of language may seem insignificant, but they will also quickly label you as a non-native speaker. Contractions are quite common in English, so it doesn't hurt to pay attention to common ones and practice using them in speech. Please note that this makes speech more informal, and it is still incorrect to use contractions in formal written English. Slang goes hand in hand with contractions. Even though it doesn't specifically reduce your accent, it will help with your ability to understand others speaking English, and it will also decrease the likelihood that you are subconsciously seen as a non-native speaker. The best way to learn slang is to have conversations with people in the area that you intend to visit. The reason that this is important is because slang evolves uniquely in different geographical areas. Even moving across a country can result in people using terminology that you may never have heard before. Using slang from a previous area or country in a new location can result in confusion until slang is figured out. Number 6. Practice, practice, practice. There are many ways to do this, but regardless of the method, the principle remains the same. Practice makes perfect. I've already mentioned some passive ways to practice with listening, but other ways to practice involve speaking out loud. You can do this by repeating phrases that you hear in movies or even in videos like these. You can also take classes in person or online, or just have a conversation with another English speaker. If you can travel to an English-speaking country, living in an immersion environment and forcing yourself to interact in English is probably the absolute best way to reduce your accent quickly. You can even ask friends, teachers, or family to help correct your pronunciation so you know where you can improve. There you have it. 6 ways to reduce your accent and improve your comprehensibility when speaking English. Do you have more ideas and suggestions for how you do this? Comment below, and don't forget that you can always watch my videos more than once to really benefit from the information. Catch you next time!